All right, what's up, everybody? It is January 7th, 2016. What a freaking day, I will tell you. This is my favorite comment from every single student. This is Gabor, one of my dedicated challenge students, and he said, "Yesterday and today, I roughly made my monthly salary. Unreal what penny stocks can do." And he really says it best. Even though the markets are down 2.5%, 3% today, and the overall markets are now down 5, 6, 7% this week, making it the worst start to a January that I can remember. There's still so many plays. And, EARS is just one of them. This was a great short. I made a few hundred. Finally, I was able to short using my Interactive Brokers account. I'm also short some overnight because it's just the first down day, but I have a very small position just in case. The better short was my shorting the break of the day of the low right here, around 7:10 before it did go eventually down to 6:50. I didn't capture all of that. I didn't even capture most of that. But when I'm starting out, with Interactive Brokers and E-Trade this year, with my little experiment of starting just 12,000, when you start an account literally right at the broker's minimums, it's important to lock in a few $100 in profits just to give you some breathing room. I can afford. Right now, I have like a $40 loss overnight on this. I can afford that because I have like a $200 cushion. So that's just a little something that I think is very useful with me starting with such a small account. But I really got to talk about this overall market. We are so late in this multi-year bull market. If you look at a 10-year chart, I mean, we've come up so much, so much. This is the S&P 500, and we're just a little off our highs. So I don't know why there are so many dip buyers saying, "Oh, we're going to go right back to our highs." Let the whole freaking market crash. Don't worry about the market. Don't be like this long-term investor right now. Focus on whatever is moving. And thankfully, we have a lot of stuff moving. First, before I get into stocks, I have to mention these sales that are 30, 40, 50% off. They are coming to a close this weekend. Okay? Miley's excited about the sale ending. I'm excited, and we're finally working our way through all the email questions. So you have roughly 3 days to capture all of these savings on these newsletters, and on all of these DVDs. And the sale will not be coming around anytime soon again. So I highly suggest you take advantage of that. But let's first talk about some plays. INVT is the main play today. This is just absolute junk. And does that matter? No. There's a lot of people who are saying, "Oh, you should never buy any junky companies. Penny stocks are so risky." Listen, it's January. The January effect spikes junk. It's best you realize this. This was on my watch list the other day. They had some pre-market news. Nothing huge, huge news related, but anything that has spiked recently can spike again in January. Look at this. One spike, two spikes. This is the third spike in just a few days. And this was the biggest spike, probably because it's January. And props to so many of you guys who banked on this. I gotta call out a few people. I couldn't even keep up with how many people were banking. Rich was in at 192, out at 227. Ryushin was in at 220, out at 250. So they're each making roughly 30 cents a share. Not bad for a $2 stock, right? KMCD had a big day the other day, made another 400. NL Stevens made nice, what is this, 15%. I like this. Day trade amateur locked in 6,000 short on cool because, as I've said in recent watch lists, it's not just about which stocks can spike. It's also about, wait a minute, these stock spikes are very, very temporary. And cool was a great short from the 160s down to the 130s. And day trade amateur, whatever your name is. That's some solid profits. Made 3,000 bucks, or locked in 6,000 short shares. Yeah, so $3,000 profits. Belt, I love this. He says, "Damn, that was fast. Made 2,000 on INVT. Thank you, Rich72, for the chat room alert." And I got to give props to Rich72. He was the first, I think, in the Tim Alerts chat room to mention INVT pre-market this morning. Nearly 1,000 of you were in the chat room, and that's what you got to do in January. Pre-market, 9 a.m., 9:15 a.m. Eastern, 9:30 a.m. Eastern. When you see all of these people who made money today, it's all in the first 20, 30 minutes. That's the easiest spiking of the day. I mean, look at cool yesterday. That was the big morning spike. Today, INVT. is the big morning spike. So you naysayers and you negative people who just want to rip on penny stocks all the time, that's fine. Ignore it, okay? The rest of us will just try and buy these stock spikes. I should mention that I actually tried to buy INVT right around in here in the 220s. I missed my execution. I still alerted the chat room. I was like, damn, I missed my execution. And it's actually probably a good thing, because had I gotten executed here at like, it was like 9:32, 9:33 in the morning, right? Had I been executed by 9:36, it's already up to 3. So this is only gonna be a 3 or 4 minute trade. By the time I even write out the alert, I send the alert, you guys read the alert, you know, it's already gonna have moved a dollar a share. So sometimes these morning spikes, alerts are irrelevant. You need to be prepared ahead of time. And that is why I talk about my DVDs and video lessons so much, because that prepares you. You don't need alerts. That's what differentiates my chat room from every other chat room. That's why we have the biggest chat room and we have the most millionaire students. So where was I? Bayello was in at 191, out at 237. Oh, there's more too. I don't want to forget anybody. Ranillo made 20 cents a share. M Street was in at 227, out at 250. Costas actually shorted ears before me. And I love this. You know, I was shorting ears at 710 before it hit 650. So there's roughly 60 cents a share from my short, but it was on my watch list. And guess what? It dropped a dollar a share from when several students who were learning to trade on their own shorted. And that's beautiful. Submersed made 145 bucks. You know, making fun of his small account. Don't make fun of your small account. We all start somewhere. We're not all trust fund babies. And my best students actually begin with a few thousand dollars. And that's awesome to make 50 cents a share on a $2 stock. Here is Cody Bosnos in at 242, out at 3. So nice 20% move. My 2 cents made a 6% gain, and then another 19% gain, and then another 17% gain. If you can trade it multiple times, that's cool. Trade it as long as it's spiking. Tate was in at 233, out at 285. Pereer was in at 240, out at 286. My fifth trade ever. Just 200 shares, but that's awesome. You're getting used to it. Unknown CPU was in at 2, out at 236. Should have held, but still made 500. Never feel guilty if you make 500. You know, I missed my execution. I made zero. I was trying to buy 1,000 shares. And it would have been, I probably would have been out for like 500. But Dr. Sandra made a nice 20%. Nose News made 250 bucks in 120 seconds. I like this. Jules made 200 in less than 10 minutes. Butterfingers, look at this, was in and out, you know, for 750 bucks there. And then another like 750 bucks here. And then, what is this? Another 800 bucks. So that's like 2000 plus. And Butterfinger says, I guess it's okay to trade scared as long as there's money to be made. Correct. It's okay to trade scared. If you can make $2,000, that's how my millionaire students and I became millionaires. And look at this, it just keeps going. Matt was in the 190s, out at 350, made 2,400. Ranillo sold too soon. Don't feel bad, Ranillo, it's okay. I like this, Frankie Monkey. Bought in 240s, sold at 3, made enough to buy Tim's DVD. Good. I'm glad you're reinvesting in education. It's going to pay off later. Here is Chris Brown in at 3, out or in at 2, out at 323. So over 50%, made 282 bucks on a small position. And I'm glad you're not the real Chris Brown. So instead of, you know, smacking women, you're smacking penny stocks. my dog was just like, wait, what? She just got excited, my little puppy right here. Armin made $250 profit. Willie made $430 profit. Chris still made like 200 bucks. Joe High made $627. G Copina shorted ears before me at 740. And I think he covered, actually, he said that he made his monthly salary in the past 2 days. So good job to him. Doucette was short ears from 734. That's before it dropped a dollar a share. G Copina also says this, Tim, my watch lists are exactly like yours since the month's probably beginning. I'm proud of that first steps. I'm proud of you, man. To make an entire month's salary in 2 days, you are on the right track. And, you know, he came to my Madrid meetup. He is a dedicated student. And I love to see dedication pay off, especially for trading challenge students. BirdX says that feeling when you got your ass handed to you on ears yesterday trying to short too early as you reshorted again today. And he covers at 688, kind of getting this. Yeah, it's okay to be too early. You know, it's not an exact science. At least you're on the right track. Here's Buscelli shorting ears at 730. Volition shorting at 712, covering at 685. That was very similar to my trade. Jamie made his first profits shorting ears, foxtrots. This one I love, foxtrot trades. I was buying meat last year in the 180s and 190s, and foxtrot trades apparently just held doubled the money. So patience sometimes pays off with earnings winners. And here's G Copina saying he made $1.20 per share on LEI, completely missed today's fade. It's okay, you just made your monthly salary in 2 days. So you may ask, why am I showing you all of this? Because I wanna, A, I'm proud of my students, but B, I wanna show you what to kind of aim for. You know, I know there's this whole school of thought where it's like, don't worry about what other traders are doing. Don't worry about money. Focus on the trade. I think that's bullshit. I'm sorry. I have my own teaching style. I have my own trading style. I'm here to make money. I'm here to teach others how to make money. I was a philosophy major. You don't need to give me any more trading philosophy. There's enough wannabe philosophers out there. I'm here to make money. Okay, that's what the stock market is all about. That's why I'm so proud of teaching this when you make 200, 300, 500, because it can add up to a million over time. And guess what? You can do it from any fucking where in the world. So that's what I'm here for. I know a lot of people are like, Tim, I'm not so interested in the money. I really like the social justice of shorting pump and dumps. Fine, leave your justice at home though. Okay, I am here to make money. Not necessarily all at once, not necessarily all at first. But over time, to learn strategies to make consistent profits day in, day out. The top traders that I know make money almost every single day. Not always every single day. Sometimes we're wrong. But all of the millionaire traders I know have strategies, have patterns that have made them money. Not strategies that are good for the social justice in the world, okay? There's a lot of people who think that penny stocks shouldn't even exist. And they short sell them way too early, and guess what? They're all bankrupt and they're all on Twitter and they tweet their little things. I don't give a shit about Twitter sayings. I care about making money, especially when that skill can be passed down to my students. So, LEI, I don't know if you saw my Yahoo Finance article. Again, because I'm trading with just 12,000, my trades are going to be very different from what they were last year. I'm not going to be trading that many high-priced stocks. I'm not going to be shorting that much because I'm trying to grow my account. You're going to see me trading a lot of 50 cent, $1, $2, $3 stocks because then I can buy 1,000 shares and make 500 or 1,000 pretty easily. But every now and then, when there is a supernova, stocks like LEI and GSI are good shorts. And when I had my Yahoo Finance interview, I think it was right around here when it was in the eights and nines. And I said, I think this is just a holiday short squeeze. I think it's going to fade. Now a 50% drop. No different than when I talked to the New York Times a few weeks ago now on KBIO. I actually talked to them right when I hit 40. And I said, you know what? I think this drops. Did I profit on either of them? No, because I have my own small little account right now that prevents me from really shorting that much. That said, you do have to respect the pattern. GSI is also faded quite nicely, over 50% off the day highs, off the multi-day highs. So start learning these patterns. Start, you know, recognizing what other students are doing to profit. Learn to mimic successful students. Learn to mimic these patterns that are shown on these DVDs. Somebody said that, you know, you should memorize all of these 7 steps in my Penny Stocking Framework DVD. I agree 100%. Okay? It's not about social injustice. I have to pick on that one guy. I'm sorry. There's one guy who's saying it's all a social injustice that penny stocks exist. Shut the fuck up. Okay? Be thankful that these penny stocks are so volatile and that they offer so much opportunity, long and short, if you come prepared every single day. I also have to give props to many more students. I can't even keep track of everything. Here's Luis. Bought INVT before the breakout, and he showed a nice screenshot in at 275, out at 3 and 320. Made a few hundred bucks. Here's a few of these. I actually talked about that earlier. Here's Eugene, very small account, INVT, made 45 bucks. And that's okay. It's okay to start small. He just made 50% on a penny stock that society says you should never trade. That's ridiculous. Congratulations, Eugene. Here's Greg, made $8,000 on INVT. Freaking awesome. I don't differentiate between Eugene and Greg. Whether you make $45 or $8,000, I'm proud of you either way. We all start somewhere. Don't feel bad about a small account. Here's Ivan making $118 from the challenge chat room. He was in, this is awesome trades. He bought some pre-market at 206, added to his position at 250, sold at 322 and 359. This is actually some great patience here. All within a half hour, just so you understand, you know, the potential here. So great job, Ivan. Here's Mark Crook. He's one of my top students. He has now banked nearly $500,000 and he just finally moved to Miami Beach. He was living in Miami. But I gotta show you his trades for a second because it's rather phenomenal. You know, this is his profit chart. And the only time he went sideways here was when he had his own newsletter and it was tough to try and balance, you know, the demands of giving alerts and commentary in real time with actual trading. Now what he's done is he gives alerts only to Trading Challenge students in the chat room. He doesn't feel the necessity to, you know, share every single trade. It's just whenever he has some extra time. He does video lessons exclusively for Trading Challenge students. He does the weekly webinars in addition to Tim Grittani and Mark or Michael Good. So Trading Challenge students are getting so much education from so many successful students and so many successful traders. And that's what I love. And yes, we all make money. It's not about the social fucking injustice. I don't care if you're good at spotting scams and you always short too early and you're bankrupt. You are not going to teach in my class. You need to show your trades and prove that you have made money. Otherwise, I don't believe a word that you say. There are so many shady people out there in Wall Street and in penny stocks. You need to show every single trade. And it's not easy to make $500,000 or $1 million, but it is possible. Here's April. I love that we're getting more females into trading. Made 270 bucks. She says, I'm hooked. Thank you for the opportunity to learn with you. Well, April, thank you for the beautiful comment. You know, it's an honor just to teach you, and it's so great to have students who have the right idea. So congrats, nice 10% trade there. Here's Armin making 250 bucks, and he says, I was born to teach. I didn't even expect to teach, okay? This is all kind of just going step by step. I thought I was going to be a mutual fund manager, you know, being on CNBC, getting interviewed by the Wall Street Journal, wearing a fancy suit every day and talking all the bullshit that most mutual fund managers do. As it turned out, I could not live with that bullshit lifestyle. I just want to focus on what works and what makes people money. So thank you. Congrats, Armin. Beautiful, beautiful trade here on just 200 shares. You're going to learn to respect this pattern and you're going to learn to scale up because next year you might have this same trade with 2,000 shares. And guess what? You're going to make, you know, 2,500 bucks. Sometimes you might have 10,000 shares and you're going to make nearly $15,000. So this is the right pattern to focus on with penny stocks. Jason, first trade under my chat room, made 400 shares, bought 400 shares in at 220, out at 319. Sarah, another girl, trader, fantastic. She was shorting GSI the past few days and she shorted, you know, 250 shares at 394 and covered at 216. And that's fantastic, making 43%, making 400 bucks. So good job, Sarah. And then Brandon, this I just keep getting more and more. First trade banked $208, such a surreal feeling, can't wait to trade more. Don't get addicted, okay? These trades don't always pop up every day. Right now they do because of the January effect and because the overall market is shit, but it's not always gonna be like this. So don't feel the addiction or don't listen to the addiction. Because if you try and force this every single day, you're gonna be disappointed the vast majority of the time. But on days like today, tomorrow, I hope you all come to the chat room right around the market open. There's gonna be some new morning spiker probably. Sloan, this is awesome, 40% profit. Make a plan, stick to it, played it way too safely. Kept growing. That's fine. Okay. When you're buying a stock at 163 and selling it in the 230s, that's not that safe. Okay. You're making nearly 50%. It doesn't matter that you can make 100% in a little bit. When you make 50% on a trade, that's fantastic. So congrats to Sloan. And then Wes, this is awesome. Second day with real money. He was practicing with paper money for a while. Nailed the short on EARS and WNDW for an easy $1,000. Millionaire Club coming my way. Don't get so cocky, okay? I think he said this sarcastically, but if you keep it up, yes, 1,000 here, 1,000 there. Sometimes you're going to lose 100 or 200 or 500, but you keep focusing on patterns that work, that make you money. And that's about it. I think that's, I counted roughly 39 students total. So this is 39 Student Thursday. Congrats to so many of you. There's many more, but I'm just overwhelmed. So congrats to you guys. Check out whatever is going to be hot. Be in the chat room tomorrow morning. Okay. Be in the Tim Alerts chat room. That is where the action is. That is where everyone is. If you're not in the Tim Alerts chat room, you are missing out near the market open. And don't post bullshit around the market open because we will ban you. We want to find whatever stock is moving. Ideally, there's a catalyst and it has a low market cap, low float with the potential to spike big. Sometimes you're going to miss your execution. Sometimes you're going to sell too soon. You know, I totally missed my execution today. I don't care. I was on the right track and so many more of you did execute and you nailed it. And that's what I love. So congrats again. I'm going to pick out a student of the day every day. And today's student of the day is Gabor, my trading challenge student from Europe, because he just made his monthly salary in 2 days. And that is fantastic. I'll see you guys in the chat room tomorrow.